morning, everybody.
The topic given to me is workload management. First of all, we have to see what is workload management. Workload management applies to our daily routine. No matter flying or the office, we have to be aware of this workload management so that we can process our work properly. What is workload management? Workload management is one of the 13 factors support the physiological health and safety at our workplace. So we are talking about physiological health and safety. So all these are interrelated for our airline operational, because most of the time we have to focus on safety. It involves safety. If we are not able to manage our workload properly, then we can lead to some safety issues. This is what I mean. For instance, one of the examples that I highlight here is, yesterday we were discussing about this Qantas 32, the amount of failures they had and how the crew managed their workload brought the aircraft perfectly safe on ground later in the day. So that's how it's important of how we manage the workload. Okay, there's about 5 points that I want to discuss with you. So the first point is get the priority right. What are the priority? Workload. When we have a task, we have to prioritize the task, this agent to the agency, urgent one. So when we prioritize the task based on the least to the most urgent, then we can get the things done. If not, we will fumble up. We intend to make mistake because we will be too rushing on getting the task finished. On daily life, even at work or at home, when we are meant to get our things, prioritize our staff, we will be well organized. That's the point I'm trying to say. We will be well organized in our work because we know how to prioritize our staff. Second point that I like to highlight is limit the time on single task. Human nature is we are more intent to focus on single tasks for longer period of time that will affect on the end of the day for the later staff. So we have to limit our time on the single staff. Third point will be the make the most of your mind. Our brain is there's ability to process the information on different stages. At times it can process a parallel information at time. So this kind of workload management, because you can do something else physically but you'll be thinking, processing something mentally. That's how. So we have to prioritize that which one we need to finish first. This applies to us in dispatches. Because for instance, we might be doing one of the flight plans. When we were doing the flight plans, we are doing our, there's a muscle memory is preparing the flight plan. But in the same time, you will be thinking, our mind will be processing the other information. What if this goes wrong? What if this goes wrong? This is how we manage. So when we able to do that, when we can able to do the two multitasking, when a person has the knowledge of the product, that he is multitasking, is running a parallel task processing. So if you don't have the knowledge, you won't be able to make the most of from your mind. On the fourth point is assign equally the workload. As a big organization, is a business model says that we have to optimize whatever we have. There will be a group of people working around the clock, but a person must be able enough to a leader equally distribute the workload to all the team members, so that as a leader he still can manage the workload management. So in other way, process flow is going well. At the same time, he can accomplish the given task at given time. Fifth point, must feel more in control. For workload management, the person who are dealing with engaging their fellow colleagues must be able to be more in control in order to get the result out at appropriate time. If he is out of control, the result won't be as they want, as the organization wanted. The more the person in control, the better. That's all about my workload management.
How's your workload management at the office space?
Okay, basically we, as a dispatcher, we are managing our workload pretty well, because we always emphasize on the first point I highlighted, safety. Because if we don't manage the workload properly, it will endanger the safety indirectly or indirectly. So that's why we are more serious on managing our workload.
Can we also apply workload management to our daily life management?
Yes.
Can we also apply?
Okay. It can make us a better person, more disciplined. Thank you very much.